It's a great privilege that today Mr. Rizwan Sheikh is with us at Francis Xavier Engineering College and also organizing this webinar through Priestline Info Solutions and Francis Xavier Engineering College. And he also owns his own company called Priestline Info Solutions, which is situated at Mumbai. So, Rizwan sir started his career at the age of 17, and he came into the limelight at the age of 18 when he protected many Indian websites from getting defaced by the Pakistan cyber army, where he played a major role in finding their pseudonyms. And also he has revealed numerous critical vulnerabilities, bugs, loopholes on websites and networks of major corporates and institutions, including Indian Railways, Monster India, and also many educational institutions. And also, one of the major accomplishments is that we identified so many fraudulent activities in the website. And the hallmark of his achievement is that in the Facebook, he was listed as the top of the white hat hackers in the year 2015. And Mr. Rizwan Sheikh has provided so many lectures in IIT Mumbai and in so many eminent prestigious educational institutions. And he right now he lives at Ahmedabad, and it's a great privilege that Mr. Rizwan Sheikh sir is among us to share his expertise and share his knowledge. And we are so privileged and we are so thankful to him for accepting our invitation and for coming here to host this webinar along with Francis Xavier Engineering College, Tirunelveli, Tamil Nadu. Thank you, sir, for consenting to be the resource person. And with these words of welcome, I thank the management of Francis Xavier Engineering College for giving this opportunity. And I invite Rizwan sir to take over the session of this webinar. Over to Mr. Rizwan Sheikh sir from Ahmedabad.
Right now, without wasting any time, let's begin our session where I will be not only explaining you the different types of attacks that are happening in the recent time, but as well as we are going to understand how to actually attack, and at the same time we are going to learn the countermeasure as well. I hope my audio, everyone, I'm not switching on my video at the moment because of the slow internet. More bandwidth will be utilized. But I hope my audio is clear, and I will be sharing my screen right now with everyone. Screen is... my screen is not visible. I will definitely try to help you out with another hotspot connection, but I hope it's clear now. Anytime you can simply drop a message in the chat if any issues faced. So first of all, my name is Rizwan Sheikh, and into ethical hacking, we call ourselves as an ethical hacker. Big reason behind it. Indian cyber law. In cyber, have any term known? Of course, there is a term hack to define an illegal or unethical person, but ethical hacker is the term which is in cyber law of some of the. So, if you talk about ethical and unethical hacking, there is a very thin line of difference. Myself as cyber security expert rather than using the typical word as ethical hacker. So here I begin with the session, and this is my website, rizwanonline.com. This website, which is loading, may be a bit slow because of certain remote connection issues, but it's a website. Now what if I say I will ask my friend to check my website? I will just the name of a website to him, either on WhatsApp or any chatting messenger or over email and I can enter this website and do the feedback. What if I say just by clicking on the I his computer? Yes, it is obvious possible just by clicking on the link sent by me, his computer can be compromised. Let's understand how will be learning the countermeasure, what to do and what to avoid doing when you are online. So the first thing which we are talking about is hacking into any computer system. Always remember, every computer connected will be assigned with a unique IP address. So my system is assigned with a unique IP address. By visiting on what is my ipaddress.com, I can see my IP address. I am opening this website right now and here, and my IP information table is as below, which is showing my IPv4 address as 157.43. of ISP Jio, city Lucknow, country India. This is the location where I am traveling right now, and you can see when I am connected to the hotspot connection of internet over here, the address IP. Every computer connected to internet right now, you people are connected to during this pandemic time, either from your home or from your office or from your college environment or hostel, you will be having a unique IP defined for your system. Now this IP is nothing like, but it's an address to your computer system. It's like your home address, your office address. So the IP of your home. The first thing in hacking is a hacker needs the IP address of his victim. As a hacker, if I want to hack into computer system of my friend, the first thing which I will my friend. So how can I get his IP address? Finding IP address is the first step in any hacking. And if you get the IP address, all other things are. So in order to get the IP address, we need to apply a very small hacking trick. Website which is google.com. You can see in the new tab, I just opened google.com. The left bottom side, if you watch carefully, in India, opened google.com, and it is showing me on the left hand side, India is written over here. The world war announced, I was in African nations, and when I opened google.com, so when I was in and wherever I am traveling, respective nations name over here. The big question over here is, Google knows I am Google has recorded my IP address. So this IP is recorded by Google, and Google has given me a customized version of the website, which is so Google is recording your IP address. The question is, Google to record your IP. How Google is recording IP address? Let's Google. Any website which you visit on the internet, let Google, Facebook, LinkedIn, or any private website like rizwanonline.com, abcd.com, whatsoever. Every website has the capacity of recording your IP address. Every website is aware who ISP, sort of ISP, city, location, country, state, and so on. Internet records this much information. Let's come back one step. My friend, RizwanOnline.com is one of the websites. This website also records the IP address and log this that comes to me. So as soon as the person clicks on the link by me, the first thing that's going to happen is his IP address will be recorded. Understand the countermeasure simultaneously. One single click on the link is enough to give you sufficient information that is required by the hacker to hack you. Over here, what I will be doing is I will be using a and I will be using Pro. Is nothing but basically a malicious application of Vips computer attack. Once the Trojan is injected in victim's computer system, so victim's computer system can be remotely accessed by the attacker. So a typical Trojan will be having two parts. Let's call it part number one and part number two. Part number one, you somehow have to get injected in the victim's computer, and part number two will remain with the attacker. I, as a hacker, will display you both the parts in my own system. Let me just switch on one of the Trojan file present inside my computer. You can see two file and over here. File which you whose size is less than 500 KB, that is 462 KB. This is part one of the Trojan. I become victim myself, so I am running this file in my own system. And you can see when I double click on this file, nothing happened. I press the enter button again. Nothing is happening. The person will. This file is doing nothing. When you click on it, happens. The person may ignore the file or simply delete the file. But since it's a Trojan file, the Trojan is running in the background right now. The Trojan. Any person from any corner of this world, right, can hack into my computer system remotely just with my. How? Let me show you. Let me show you. And I double click this part. Part number two. When I double click over here, you can see at the bottom line in the attacker's part, I see no connection is written over here. left bottom of the software, you can see no connection. There's an option to enter IP address of the victim. Will enter my own IP address since I am the attacker, I am the victim, and I will press the button. And you can see at the bottom line, I see the message connected to IP address. Server and client connected. And you can see how many dangerous buttons are present over here. I see an option or a button name over here with the name open. If I click on button, or the CD of my computer system will open. Since I am the attacker, I am the victim, my CD-ROM will open. But this is happens, and you can definitely. Is injected in the computer. This particular button allows me to browse an image and pop on to friend computer. So you can imagine if your friend is sitting somewhere in public, don't let you walk. All these options are available in the Trojan. Swap mouse is nothing but making left button to right click button to left click, and troubling the user. You can start any program, you can change the hearing. Go to URL is one of the best option. I can type any website in here, example google.com, and I click on go to URL button. Automatically in the and you can see I in between due to certain issues. I guess it will be clear now. That website opens in the victim's comp. File manager is one of the best option to remotely all files and folders present into victim's computer system. Then there are so many other buttons like message manager. Message manager is one of the best app with your email. You can type any message like surprise, you are hacked. And you can see up automatically. So this message will pop up onto the computer system. I quickly go and measure, and I use this particular process impfile.exe end process. Now when I try to click the bottom line, I see couldn't connect to the IP. Imagine that I can do. Now, think was IP address of the victim, and second thing, somehow we have to send password to victim. If you can perform these two steps, definitely unethical hacking activity can be performed. Now we are thinking as an unethical hacker so that we can do the ethical hacking part in much better way. I'm going to talk about the and countermeasures as well, where any crime committed can be tracked, the attacker will be caught. So finding IP address, you know, you can do the, but how to send this thing? Another way is gifting a pen drive, sending file okay, uploading on some link and sending it as an attachment or a link in the email or any messenger. So there are so many other ways as well to send this particular Trojan file. Countermeasures, very simple. Never click an attack. Arrested. One single click on the link is actually revealing out your IP address and other information. One single click on any malicious attachment, no, what's going to happen. Right? I hope the countermeasures are quite clear for everyone. Proceeding further, in the current era, lot of things, especially during the corona period of time, issues which are very trending so with you email. If you see, there are two things in this, email and phishing. If you are aware about Chinese cyber attack, lot of internet websites were targeted and lot of Indians targeted. Okay, so if my auto is again, just leave a message in the chat that I can just check my internet connection again. So you might be aware about the recent China cyber attack where lot of email IDs of Indians were targeted, lot of Indians users were targeted. Email being sent from email IDs like 19gov.in. If you see this email ID, gov.in belongs to Government of India. And unethical hackers China were using such spoofed email IDs to send mass amount of emails. It doesn't mean that this particular government of India email ID is compromised. It is just email spoofing or forging. Email spoofing / forging. I would say this is just stealing identity, or not even stealing, spoofing or using someone else's identity to send an email. It is not required any email account, but without username and password. And I think it's from Government of India. They send a very attractive email content containing some kind of financial benefit of good news people or MSMEs, and they sent attaching and sending phishing links. Now phishing is nothing but creating a very similar looking login page like the original website. Let me give you an example. Suppose the original website of one of the bank is ICICIbank.com. It's a very famous bank's website. Person can a very similar looking domain name, which would look something like ICICIbank.com or something like ICICIbank.com. If you watch these two domain names, both to each other, and this domain name can be misused as a type domain. It means the website, you may log in over here thinking it's original web. So a person like me can definitely create a complete ICICIbank.com and host it on my fake domain name, which is com. Anyone entering their username and password on the server? Anyone entering their username and password on my fake website will come to my server. And the number of so this thing is always remember countermeasure to verify the domain property in order to avoid getting from privacy to this kind of attack. I'm writing two domains. Suppose there is a website which is icicparent.com. And second is this. One website is phishing. Two you are excited. One website is real. Can you type which one is real? Can anyone tell me what website is phishing and what website is real? Take a message in the box. Website is phishing. And one is real. I hope yeah, and first website is fish. And fellow saying both are real websites. Let me tell you, the first website is a real website, the website is a phishing website. Web 2 is phishing website. I hope my is now clear. And second, you see. Here the domain name is icicibank.com, whereas here the domain name is indianlogin.in. To tell you an example, suppose I have a domain name which is Rizwan Online. So I can create abc.com. I can create com.abc.rizwanonline.com. I can also create I. Mean this website now will. It hosted as a subdomain on my website, which is subdomain.com, and any credentials username entered over here will be stored in RizwanOnline.com server. So over here, if you see the domain name carefully, two subdomains are created and the actual domain is indianlogin.in. Whereas if you see this name, if they add that this is a fake phishing site login and still I logged in, I am pretty sure the credentials go only to this particular server, which is the official ICICI Bank server. But over here, if I enter any credentials, it goes to this particular server, which is not the official ICICI Bank website. So this is what you have to take care of. You have to carefully see the URL, watch the domain name properly, make sure you don't have your credentials at any age, and losing all your username passwords. I hope you are pretty sure about this phishing thing and you will be careful with this type of attack. Okay, now the recent trend which is going on is suspension of around Chinese application on 59 different apps. What? Camps can. And many other applications, including WeChat Messenger. These applications they will only be in India on Google Play Store and App Store. It doesn't mean if your cell phone work normally, but app will be removed from these application stores and no new users can download it. The old subscribers can still continue it. And if you see all the applications mentioned over here, the same application, and the suspension of the application is not officially for boycott of any particular Chinese product. And this is because of certain privacy concerns, and those privacy concerns include government. Even an app like TikTok was where they're simply monitoring on users' activity. TikTok officially demanded permission of accessing your phone gallery and camera. And silently starts downloading certain data from your gallery or your cell phone to certain servers based in China, and they dump the data over there. So this is one of the major privacy concerns. Even governments of India's data can be stolen because many of the officers were using such kind of applications as well. Thus, Government of India has came up with an order to block these applications in India. Let me show you how typical malware works. Suppose I made one of the genuine application, which is android.apk. This application can be made into like a calculator application or an application which has some other particular now what I'm doing, I is in my hand right now, and you can see this application is actually a malware which indirectly in the background is stealing the information from cell phone where the app is installed. First, application is get installed, and I'm going to display dashboard. The application is let me open this website for you. First, I am of the database and the hosting provider. Since the data is replicating in real time from my phone to this particular database, and call software with the name Pristine Spy, since we made it in our company, and I'm logging to my database in order how exactly this data. This is some state sponsors of some other country, including Pakistan, or India. So such kind of application helpful, and you can see the database is working. And all these data are getting fetched. On the left side, you can read there is something written as call logs. Call logs is nothing but all dial, receive, and install data. I clicked on the call log button. Depending upon the internet speed, it will load and display list of just below the call logs, there are messages, contact book button where I can all the SMSs and entire phone book of the victim self. You can see the dial call logs button is on, tab is on. I can find all date, time, duration of every damn call made from this particular cell phone. Not only call logs, but all recording, recall, and then there's so many other options, including GPS tracking, keystrokes recording, running on live camera, and completely working on social media activities like Facebook, Twitter, keeping an eye on browsing history, etc. All these informations is possible online. Understand how danger works. Minimum phone in their hand, and we keep it 24/7 with us. And many of us have got the habit of using our cell phone, and this is the last thing we use before going to bed, and the first thing we use while we wake up. So every data is there, for chatting to our phone or to our personal photographs, to information of family, and everything will be present in the cell phone. Now suppose if your cell phone is compromised, then it's a question of compromising your majority of the life. So we have seen many of the cases where many of the females were targeted. The content were stolen, and initially they were defamed. Demand amount as well. So this is how typically it functions. Having said that, we have learned few of the basic types of attack which are happening, and which are very common. But the hacking is ever evolving. You never know tomorrow something new will come up. So this is the field where you have to be always upgraded. And universities have formed certain hacking CHCPT. These are the training programs for some detailed content of cyber security, vulnerability assessment, penetration testing, and abuse mitigation. And conditions like this, he will be working as an intern on live cybercrime projects. Performance actually works with multiple law enforcement bodies. Once you have a kind of experience to work on such a project, definitely finding a job won't be a tough task. And we have seen for the first time the number of openings profile has all reduced when compared to any other domain. It is definitely cybersecurity has a very wide and very huge scope. I request everyone to more active into this, because India is compliance system of India, government of India's body required security experts down the line. The interviews, and you know what happened, we couldn't even meet on that. And the country are very less. So anyone who is having talent is definitely an opportunity. So I if there is any question, queries with anyone, please type in the chat box. I'll try to help you and assist you with the queries, and I'll try to answer. Can get resolution. So I have one of the first who is asking, can you suggest some useful budgeted course for cybersecurity? So what we are going to do is I will ask my team to send email to everyone. Everything. And definitely the college has done a wonderful job by inviting and creating such a wonderful event, because we have seen the people who are actively spreading the cybersecurity knowledge and awareness. And due to lack of support from various colleges and government bodies, this is not easy possible. So I especially want to thank the professor and principal of the college to thank for the students, since it's a good opportunity and learning opportunity for the people as well. So the question answer dais is still open for people. If you want to type and ask anything, definitely. I will be sharing my email ID with you so that you can communicate anytime for any queries. My email ID is contact@rizwanonline.com and typing wow. And you can definitely connect me on any networking site like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. I am present everywhere. Any kind of doubt, query in the future, you can definitely connect me online. Even if you ping me on Facebook or Instagram at night 2 a.m., I won't reply, but definitely in the morning, I will definitely try to reply you. So thank you very much for attending such a wonderful session where I try to share maximum amount of information. I hand over the mic to the host again, and I wish you all the best. Please stay safe and secure both in physical world and cyber world as well. Thank you very much.
Sir, there are a few questions in the chat box, sir. Can you please take it, sir?
People are asking the question about how can they will be dropping an email to every person who is joining over here. So they will be receiving the details on the email. And there are a few people who are asking whether the certificate is provided. Yes, certificate will be provided to you. College will. And I don't see any other or retype the question again, I will definitely try.
Sir, one of area is ransomware. It's high in India, sir. Can you please elaborate about ransomware, sir, in India?
Sure. Thing about ransomware. So ransomware is used in the physical if you see kidnappers, whenever they kidnap someone, they demand ransom amount in order to release the person. The same way in the virtual world, ransomware is something where a malicious software gets injected inside your computer and all your file folders will be locked and encrypted. None of the files will be in readable format. And a message will pop up saying that please pay us this amount as ransom in bitcoins in order to get your files back. The encryption is of so high level that if you try to decrypt the files manually, it will take ages. So the only way to recover your file is by paying the ransom amount. A bit history about this. The Bitcoin was launched in the year 2009-2010. It was anonymous, untrackable. And during that particular period, particular time itself, ransomware came to picture for the first time. There was a ransomware with the name CryptoLocker, CrypTo. CryptoLocker was the first ransomware of the world. Started attacking in US. Many computer systems were infected. And entire US government were in shock because as of now, as of 2009, either virus or Trojan were into picture. Virus either used to delete the file or Trojan either used. But ransomware was neither deleting the file nor stealing the file. Instead, it was locking the file inside the computer system itself. And they were demanding ransom amount in order to release your files to yourself. So that was first of its kind. And when CryptoLocker came into picture, one of the very law enforcement agency of US under FBI, they made an official statement saying that do not pay ransom amount to these hackers. We will quickly come up with a solution. This was the statement made by law enforcement agency. And you know what happened? The very next day after this statement, CryptoLocker got injected in FBI systems and FBI ended up paying a ransom amount to get their files back. So that's why it was very dangerous and it created mass havoc across US. After that, so many other ransomware came into picture, right from CrimeLocker. Then recently, WannaCry ransomware, Petya, Petra ransomware, they created very mass havoc across the world. So it's kind of a pandemic in the physical world, like ransomware in the virtual world is something where it is having or creating a mass impact as well. So that was about ransomware. So I have two other questions in the chat box. I'll just read the question for everyone. So the question, can you please suggest few steps to protect our mobile phone from any kind of hacking activities? So you just have to follow simple cyber hygiene methods. Just follow do's and don'ts. Remember, precaution is better than countermeasure. I would suggest not to install any third-party application which is not downloaded from official Play Store or App Store. Having said that, this doesn't mean that if you download an application from Play Store or App Store, it is completely safe. No, but still limit your usage. Install the application only which is required and important. Download the application from Play Store which belongs to reputed companies only. There are many companies which are launched by individuals who are sitting in some small town across any other location, remote location. They have launched a malicious application and they are remotely spying on people by those applications. So you have to always verify who the company is of any application. then if you feel you are already infected or injected, then you have to scan your cell phone manually, go in settings, go list of installed applications, and check all the applications which are running. You have to uninstall any of the application which is unknown or malicious, which you find in the list. So that's the only thing which I can suggest, and these are the basic do's and don'ts. And be careful, do not click on any forwarded messages, links sent on WhatsApp. It may be a malware or phishing link again. Okay, I hope that's the answer to your mobile query. There is another question from Soumya. The question is, in India, other than Information Technology Act of 2003, ITAC 2000, and then the amendments came into picture, are there any other laws that protect the privacy of citizens? For instance, HIPAA. Okay. Now the question is whether there is any other law apart from Indian ITAC 2000 that protects privacy of users. So India is coming up with Data Protection Act and Data Protection Bill. It is already made live and active, but it's under development again. So under Data Protection Act, the data that is going to be shared out of India or hosted somewhere outside, and even the companies which are going to host data in India, they will be bound to certain restrictions, including encryption mandatory, so that it cannot be stolen. So the Data Protection Bill, you can study about the research, which is, and CERT India is giving certain more guidelines to it so that it will be upgraded again. And Indian cyber law was formed in the year 2000, so it is always known as ITAC 2000. Few amendments came in the year 2008 and 2013. So 2003 there was no amendment, 2008 and 2013 were the amendment, and still it's under development stage, and many of the laws are made yet. So HIPAA is especially for medical professionals based out of US. So any company which is doing transaction or serving people across US, they have to undergo the HIPAA compliance checks, HIPAA. Okay, so there's a question from Mohammed, whether the question is it safe to have camera in our mobile phone which is already installed and banned by Government of India? So I recommend to follow the order of Government of India, since they are banning the application across Play Store and App Store, which is banned by Government of India. I request everyone to uninstall it. The ban announced by Government of India is because of certain privacy concerns where the apps are stealing the data. So if the app is still present inside your mobile phone, definitely you will be vulnerable. So it's always better to uninstall, and you can try any alternatives available for it. Feedback link will be sent when the event is off, so you can send the feedback. Okay, any other question, let me know. Action. Is Truecaller legal app? Yes, Truecaller is a legal application hosted on the Play Store, but again a Chinese based application, and many allegations have been based against it as well, which is also one of the allegations based users data. So I suggest avoid using Truecaller as well.
Okay, sir. If you have any other further questions, you can please ask, or we can conclude the session. So shall we conclude the session, sir?
Yeah.
So on behalf of Francis Xavier Engineering College, Tirunelveli, Tamil Nadu, with a grateful heart to the Lord Almighty, we thank you one and all for making this webinar a grand success. First of all, it's my immense pleasure to thank the Lord Almighty for making this webinar a grand success. And also, it's my privilege and my honor to thank the management of Francis Xavier Engineering College, our chairman, our managing director, for all their support and motivation in conducting this webinar. Also, it's my honor to thank Dr. K. Jayakumar, the general manager for development of Francis Xavier Engineering College, for all his motivation and for all his initiative in conducting this webinar. Also, it's my privilege to thank Dr. Velmurugan, the principal of Francis Xavier Engineering College. And also it's my great honor to thank Mr. S. Krishnakumar, the director for Applied Labs. This program is conducted in collaboration with Applied Labs, the next generation network Applied Lab of Francis Xavier Engineering College with the Cisco Academy in association with the Computer Science and Engineering Department. I thank the director of Applied Labs. Also, it's my honor to thank Professor P. Brindra, the colleague and comrade of myself in the Computer Science and Engineering Department. I also thank all the team members of Computer Science and Engineering Department for all their support in conducting this webinar in a grand manner. Heart full of gratitude to Rizwan Sheikh sir for coming here and to this webinar and sharing his expertise in midst of his busy schedule. Sir, your schedule was, your talk was very informative in the area of phishing and also in the area of ransomware, and also there was a lot of demos which you conducted and which you showed, and it was very useful for us. And from the bottom of our heart, we wish to thank you. We are sitting in Tamil Nadu and you are sitting in Gujarat, and you are delivering this lecture for us, and it's a kind of a national webinar, and wish to thank you for all the support and for sharing your expertise. Also, it's my honor to thank Bhumika ma'am, your colleague, for all her coordination and cooperation in conducting this webinar in a grand manner. Last but not the least, it's my immense pleasure to thank all the participants of this webinar who have joined with us. Though there was a delay in initial, you thank you for all your understanding and all your cooperation. And the feedback link will be, it has been sent by in your email, and it has enabled. You can take the feedback link. And if there is any issues, you can please contact us in offline. So thank you one and all for this great opportunity of conducting this webinar. Thank you once again, and God bless. And thank you one and all for making this webinar a grand success. Thank you, Rizwan sir, for coming and sharing your expertise once again. Thank you, Bhumika ma'am. Thank you one and all.
Thank you.